very much. And what a pleasure and an honor it is to be here with you today. And it's a wonderful tribute by a couple of great friends, former friends. Now, you know what? I think Donny Osmond may have struck me out once. I really do. Everybody else did. He probably got me too. He probably got me too. Anyway, I wasn't a big-time bonus player when I signed with the Braves. Very modest $3,000 bonus, which kind of aggravated my old man because he didn't have that kind of money to put out. And, but the Braves took it. Milwaukee, Philadelphia. Hey, congratulations to Philadelphia. Beautiful. Matter of fact, Philadelphia is the only place I ever had a fight with a fan. Somebody from behind our dugout at old Connie Mack Stadium was really on me. And finally, you know, you get enough of that stuff, and they started talking about my family, and your reaction is to dive into the seats. And I got a couple of good punches in, and the bad thing is it's going to be a court suit and a lawsuit. You're going to court, and I can remember that day in court, she was sitting there with her attorney. Still pretty well marked up. I never made a lot of money in baseball. I think the most I ever made as a player, maybe $12,000-$13,000, I think, is the most. And seven of that came from selling other players' equipment. If you wanted something, I'd get it for you. The price is right. I've been around baseball a long time. As I said, you know, you pick up tips when you know your career is kind of it's over. You know, you're coming to the end of the line. You know, you're playing in games, and you look down at the third base coach for a sign. He turns his back on you. Tell you you're playing a night game, and you get to the ballpark and finally played that afternoon. I remember the Braves told me that they were going to make me a coach after releasing me in 1967, releasing me as a player, that I would be I'd be coaching second base. So again, I knew my time might be up. But I've had a great time in baseball, a great time as a broadcaster. I don't think there's anything better for baseball than radio. Let me just mention the brass. The audience doesn't know a thing until you tell them what's going on. Television, you can see everything. You talked about how green the grass is. I look at how much of the grass can I smoke. I try anything once. But that's the love of baseball, and that's what the fan, the listener, they don't know anything until you tell them about it. And that's what makes radio baseball the best. It really is. I mean, people, you don't sit in your houses all day long during the summertime and watch a game on television. You're outside, you got a radio with you. You're driving around in a car, you got a radio with you. And that's really what makes baseball so exciting for the fan. You have to love the game too, and I think I've always been privileged because of the fact that I'm an ex-player. And I know what it's like to be in a clubhouse, to be down 10 games, and you've lost five in a row, and you're getting your brains beat out by the writers and the media. So I know what that's like, and it helps me as far as the broadcasts go. To have been a player, again, I was on a world's champion.